A store clerk who shot a beer thief dead was a convicted murderer, but for only a few days. A jury found Juan Romero guilty, but gave him no jail time. Less than a week later, the judge found out that's not possible under Texas law. A law change in 2007 says that probation should have never been an option. New at 6, KXAN's Chris Sadeghi has more on how this mistake was made and how all sides agreed to fix it.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Juan Romero, guilty of the offense of murder.
Protecting property or murder? It was a case that brought out a lot of opinions, but in the opinion of the jury, Juan Romero was a murderer who did not deserve jail time. But a tiny line in the big book of Texas law says there's no such thing.
It was missed by myself and by the defense attorney and by the judge.
Prosecutor Rob Drummond showed us exactly where they went wrong. It's a slight and confusing change in wording from the 2007 code, effective when the crime happened, to the current 2009 code. It says probation is not allowed in murder cases, but the language fooled everyone.
They literally listed five twice.
It was very confusing.
Romero's attorney, Pat McNellis, says in 2007, lawmakers adopted Jessica's Law, taking probation out as a possibility for those convicted of violent crimes against children. A different section under the same number is where this case was affected.
The other, with the exact same number, said, and you can't do it for murder. That's not normal.
As a result, the wrong procedure was followed in Romero's case, a case McNellis says is the perfect example of why juries shouldn't be handcuffed with such laws.
We can't ever paint a broad stroke and say, murder means this, sexual assault of a child means this.
So what happens to Romero? The murder conviction was thrown out, and he has pleaded to a manslaughter charge, giving him the same probation sentence the jury decided upon. Rather than retry the case, both attorneys think this is the right conclusion that reflected the jury's feelings.
We need to respect what the jury worked for 13 hours of deliberation to arrive at.
I thought it was an extremely just result.
A just result they arrived at despite a wrong turn. Chris Sadeghi, KXAN, Austin News.